Excel is a common format used for testing, and you can use it for testing your models with Simulink Test. This anti-lock braking system has inputs of type bus and enumeration, and signals of interest marked for logging that we want to verify. There also are some tunable parameters that control the simulation. Let me show you how to create an Excel template spreadsheet for the model that can be populated with data for testing. In the test manager, I start by creating a new test file based on spreadsheet. A wizard opens that steps us through the process. First, I select the option to create a new test template spreadsheet file for the test scenarios. Next, I specify the model name and optionally select a test harness. I now select the attributes to include in my spreadsheet. I will include all the input signals, parameters, and baseline comparison signals. I can filter the attributes, parameters, and outputs. The wizard has detected automatically the attributes in the model. I will filter out the engage input parameter. Tolerances can also be set. In this step, I can specify the number of scenarios that I want to create. Each sheet in Excel is a scenario. I can also specify a base name for naming the sheets. Lastly, I specify the locations for my test file and the spreadsheet template file. By default, both the test file and spreadsheet template file are created in the same directory. After clicking Done, the new test is created using the spreadsheet. Let's look at the template spreadsheet that was created in Excel. This template can be used to specify the test scenarios. The bus input has been split to its leaf elements. Here are the parameters and the output signals populated with the current baseline. Now we enter the data for the scenario. The input signals are pasted into the spreadsheet. A parameter is changed for the scenario. One important thing to note here is that the parameters can be scalars, vectors, or any MATLAB expressions or script. The tolerances for baseline signals are set. Absolute, relative, and time tolerance are supported. More scenarios can be created by simply copying the sheets and editing the data for each scenario. At this point, the data for the test scenarios was edited, and two additional scenarios are created. After saving changes in the Excel, we return to the test manager. The refresh operation updates the test case with the additional test scenarios. Now we can run the test case, and each of the scenarios are run as an iteration. We can expand the results and look at signals. In summary, you can define an Excel template to specify inputs, parameters, tolerances, and baseline comparison signals. Each sheet defines a separate scenario that can be simulated. Changes in the Excel file are automatically included in the test case when it's run.